over a dozen black boxcars parked on the tracks.
Today's weather report, guys. Well, we're all right. It's supposed to get up to 10 inches, it says. So, we'll see.
We all looked inside and saw a shocking sight. There were shackles welded inside as if to hold people prisoners.
Right.
We panicked, we freaked, we were filled with terror. We turned around, followed those tracks, headed to our host's family's home, and she said, you never should have gone to that area. There are usually federal guards with rifles guarding that area. You could have been killed.
Are the prisoner boxcars, concentration camp transports, somehow connected to the alleged Nazi presence in the colony? And if so, why would U.S. federal guards be protecting them? One clue leads back to the height of the Cold War, when nuclear missile control officer Robert Sauss is confronted with strange lights outside his base.
We had to report into our squadron commander's office right away. They wanted us to sign a non-disclosure statement saying that we would never talk about this.
Even though this was an unprecedented security breach, the Air Force command to sign a gag order was unexpected.
I didn't see the reason for that because we had above top secret clearance already. We had high security clearances. But they said that this was a specific incident that should never be talked about.
Right.
Sauss believes the Air Force acted as it did because it couldn't risk any information.